mean, I recognize that the idea of hegemony means that there are alternatives within, but I wouldn't call that an out, I wouldn't say that there's an outside, and I wouldn't say that the difference between a hegemonic approach and like a diagnosis of media as hegemonic and media as totalitarian would hinge on the presence of an outside. The way I see it is that under contemporary conditions of communicative capitalism, we've got global subsumption, the real subsumption of everything under capitalism or within capitalism. But this subsumption is not flat, it's uneven, there's holes and gaps in it, there's sites of retraction, sites of intensity, sites of diminishment. And so I think that part of the political, just said very kind of abstractly, that the political initiative has to come around not being outside, but identifying gaps and holes within, and occupying those gaps, pushing open those gaps, holding open those gaps. And so, and the thing that makes me kind of go back and forth between the terms hegemonic and totalitarian is actually, I mean, you know, in terms of the Hannah Arendt notion of totalitarianism, well, I think that's just a kind of, step into Cold Warism and a way to diminish the contribution of socialism and communism to the 20th century by blocking it together with fascism. And so I think that version of totalitarianism is not really helpful, and that totalitarianism isn't really a kind of good technical term, right? It's too kind of embedded in this Cold War ideology. But the thing that makes me not reject it completely in the question is the idea that there is something all encompassing, which I would accept. Right?
Yeah, I take your point about the historical association of it. But for me, and the reason I mobilize this is that for so long we understand the political system as a hegemony, and by doing so, I think we give it legitimacy. So we say, okay, it's not so bad, it is hegemonic, we can deal with this. But if we realize that in fact it is tyrannical, then perhaps political strategies then would have to be radicalized. So then we will see that retreating is not enough, and perhaps a more active kind of revolution might be necessary. This is why I pose this question.
I think what I worry about a little bit is I would want to a focus on class antagonism, and I think that ideas of despotism and tyranny can end up seeming like a kind of state over the people rather than the rule of a capitalist class and the entrenchment of the capitalist system against the working people. And so I would rather have the element of dictatorship of clapping. I would go there.